The secret of life is enjoying the passage of time. Any fool can do it. There ain't nothing to it. Nobody knows how we got to the top of the hill. Since we're on our way down, we might as well enjoy the ride. The secret of love is in opening up your heart. It's okay to feel afraid, but don't let that stand in your way. 'Cause anyone knows that love is the only road. And since we're only here for a while, might as well show some style. Give us a smile, isn't it a lovely ride? Sliding down, gliding down. Try not to try too hard, it's just a lovely ride. Now the thing about time is that time isn't really real. Just your point of view. How does it feel for you? Einstein said he could never understand it all.
Hi, Coach Graham. Jerry Landers, alumni, graduated in 1986, wishing you a great retirement. I have a lot of great memories of you and Jim back when dodgeball was a thing you could still do.
Hi, Mike. Hey, it's Jay Bradford. Just wanted to congratulate you on your retirement. It's hard to believe that you're old enough to retire. I think back to when we first taught together back in South Bend. It was my second year teaching. I learned so much from you. I always looked up to you so much and greatly appreciate your impact on my life. I thoroughly enjoyed our times together, whether it was going on trips, teaching, even going to the Indy 500 time trials or playing basketball together. So thankful for our years there in South Bend that we enjoyed with each other. And now that you're looking towards retirement, I just want to thank you for your faithful service for the Lord in Christian education and all the lives you've impacted, including my own. So thank you. And may God bless you and Julie in your retirement. Hope you have many great years together. And I think you need to come and make a trip here to Washington, D.C. and visit us. We'd love to have you. Congratulations.
Hey, Coach Graham, it's Joe Dudek. Just wanted to send a quick congratulations on your recent retirement and your entry into this new phase of life. Super exciting, I'm sure, for you and for Mrs. Graham, and congratulations on this new accomplishment. Also, just wanted to send thank you for just everything you did for me during our days at Community Baptist. Wendy asked me to put this together if I would consider it, and just that ask brought up a lot of memories that I had forgotten about and things that maybe things that I tried to forget about that haven't been able to. You know, we certainly had an interesting relationship back then since I dated your daughter during the days that I played at Community Baptist. I had recollections of going to your house so much during that time. And it seems in my memory that every time I went to your house, you had Welcome Back Cotter on Nick at Night every time. And, you know, in my house, we didn't have cable. So anytime I saw Nick at Night, it was such a novelty for me. So I don't know that it was on all that much, but I just remembered like, oh yeah, Coach, yep, he introduced me to Welcome Back Cotter. So maybe you could connect to his story since he was a teacher, you're a teacher. But also had some memories that just came back to me on the basketball court. One, I haven't been able to forget because guys like Colin Van Dyne, Todd Allen, Jason McClure won't let me forget about it. I think it was a game at Heritage Hall you had wanted to do. Wanted us to pass four or five times before we shot. I think we passed two, maybe three times. The ball landed in my hands. I was at the top of the key, nobody on me. I, of course, launched a three because why not? I'm never that open. And I missed it, which explains why I was that open. You either call the timeout or the next stoppage of the ball, you pulled me out immediately. And they'll always remember that you said, guess who's sitting at the end of the bench, Joe. So I don't know why that they couldn't remember. They won't let me forget that and why that comes in their mind, but they love bringing that back up. So thank you for that. But there were some good times too that came back. I was thinking about the semifinal game at the state championship, I think my senior year, I believe against Baptist Academy. I remember you pulling me aside at halftime and just telling me that I had been jogging up the court most of the first half. And I really needed to hustle, just run hard up the court, and paid off. Ended up scoring like the first 6 or 8 points of the second half. And I just always appreciated that about your coaching, is that it wasn't universal for the entire team. You were very present of who's doing what and who's not doing what, and how can we better our games. And always appreciated that. Also thought about your push for the Pyramid of Success with John Wooden. You know, I looked that up too, just in before recording this, and you know, terms like cooperation, enthusiasm, self-control. I've just realized how your coaching and that pyramid and your expression of that have carried forth in my coaching. I've had opportunities to coach baseball teams, basketball teams, referee, umpire, and it's been interesting to see how those building blocks in that pyramid have continued forth even to this day. Like right now I'm coaching my son's 8-year-old baseball team, and it's been fun to see those guys and see their development, and really, again, consciously or unconsciously, be implementing these things that you taught us all these years ago. So thank you for just all your time, your energy, your commitment to me and to other people on the teams and all the teams you've coached and all the kids you've led in the classroom. So quite an accomplishment as you step into this new phase. You've impacted a lot of lives, and just thank you so much for using your gifts in this way. And I'll forever be grateful. Thank you.
Hi, Coach. Chad Blake here. Just wanted to wish you congratulations on a tremendous career coaching and teaching. Words cannot describe for me how much of an impact you made on my life in a positive way. And I guess the only thing I can really say is thank you. I love you. I miss you guys. And I really hope that with this time, you and Julie can go out and really experience life and enjoy kind of the next step on your journey. So again, sorry I can't be there this weekend. Want to thank Wendy and everybody that put this together. Again, as of what I feel like your honorary son, I'm sure I'm one of many. Just want to tell you that we love you and we can't wait to see you soon.
Hello, this is Jane Plouffe, and I'm so happy to hear that you're retiring. And I remember you whenever I was in, doing volleyball, and I loved you as a coach and all that. So, again, congratulations.
Happy retirement, my Graham. Ron Halbert here from Indiana. I attended Indiana Christian Academy, Anderson, Indiana, from 1975, 1988, and by far you were my most favorite teacher and coach, role model, mentor, friend of the family. You meant so much to my parents, my brother. You coached him as well. It's awesome that you're retiring and you're going to move on to the next step. Favorite times with you? I played basketball for 3 years. And there were so many good times in that. Had a little success along the way. And I guess I can narrow it down to one time. In 1986, you transported me to Scroon Lake, New York, to the Word of Life Christian Camp. Well, I spent 4 weeks there. We had a long drive out there in a diesel Chevy van. A long time ago, but that was a memorable time for me. And I'm so happy that you made your retirement. And I know you've affected many kids like you've affected me. So, happy retirement. Say hi to Julie for me. God bless you.
When I think of Mike Graham, I think of somebody who was a humble servant, a wonderful teacher, and a Christ follower. And I actually get kind of emotional thinking about him as a person and all of the years of pouring into kids who oftentimes didn't want to be poured into. Mr. Graham was a great teacher. I remember him getting super excited, getting on desks, teaching history, probably to wake us stupid kids up, but also a humble man who would also teach us about Christ and the Bible. And I just remember how hard he worked. He would drive the bus to basketball games and volleyball games countless times. He was volleyball coach to my sisters. He was my basketball coach. I remember before he was my coach, he actually taught me how to shoot a better jump shot. I remember being in the gym just like it was yesterday and him showing me how to square up, catch the ball, do a quicker release. And it honestly allowed me to be a much better shooting guard. So I owe that to Mike Graham. The thing that sticks out the most to me though about Mr. Graham, Mike Graham, is, we had a lot of fun, so many laughs, so many wonderful memories, honestly. But he was one of those men whose family stands out to me. His wife, Julie, was possibly one of the sweetest women I knew, and his daughters as well. He had, God really blessed him with a wonderful family and has blessed him. I just think about his girls and just how much they loved their dad and their mom. And that's legacy. That's something you can't replace. He poured into hundreds of kids, but his family loves that man. And I don't blame them. Mike Graham is one of those men that I will forever be indebted to. And my memories of him are only good. He was a good man, is a good man. And anybody who has sat under his coaching or teaching or mentorship has only been blessed. So congratulations on the retirement. And I know your work here is not done, and you're going to continue to bless people throughout your life. You've certainly blessed me, and I think about you often. God bless you.
Hello, Coach Graham. This is Kevin Plew. I want to, first of all, wish you happiness and congratulations on your retirement. I know that you have spent many years in Christian education, for which I'm thankful. When I think of you, I think of you as coach. You're the coach that I think of, just because you were my varsity basketball coach. I love basketball, and I want to thank you for the time investment that you have made in your players. I think of all the hours in coaching, and now as a school administrator, I can better appreciate how much you invested in your time in coaching and teaching. Thank you for the basketball camps that you ran for us as students, even taking us down to Ben Davis High School and letting us play there on the courts in the summers. Just great memories and great opportunities for us and developing our growth. And I want to thank you also for being a great example, an example of a Christian man, what it meant to be a Christian, a great example of being a godly father and husband. And those are priceless treasures that I can take with me. And so I really appreciate it. I would have never thought that I'd be back here at Indiana Christian Academy, as a school administrator, as a basketball and volleyball coach. And I owe a lot of that to you and your investment in my life. And so I just want to say thank you, and I hope you enjoy your retirement.
Hey, Coach Graham, heard about your retirement. Very happy to hear that you're finally going to get to relax and enjoy a little bit of life beyond Christian school and teaching people and coaching. I just want to tell you that, thank you, and from the bottom of my heart, how much I appreciate all the investment that you put into kids across the span of your career, and in particular, the time you put into me. The principles you taught me during my years in high school and coaching me in basketball, I believe contributed to making me the man I am today, and I want to thank you for that. So again, happy and congratulations on your happy retirement.
Hi, Coach Graham. This is Josh Plew. I just wanted to congratulate you on your retirement. I was looking at your LinkedIn profile, and I saw that you had over 45 years of faithful service to the Lord, and I just wanted to thank you for the impact you had on my life, and just a testimony to your faithfulness to the Lord as you served Him for those many years. Lord bless you as you enter your retirement.
Happy retirement, Mike. Hey, it's good to see you guys, or I guess I'm not really seeing you, but we're sending a message of the fact that you are going to retire, and that's awful great thing that you get to do. I know I was able to do that about a year and a half ago, and it is a very good thing. And we just appreciate you guys so much, especially the time we had together at ICA and our families, and the things we were able to do together. I remember driving buses and of course coaching and just working with the students and everything that we did. We had quite a time over there with everything that went on, all the different ministries and everything. And so that was always a special time in our life. And it was good to be a part of that with you. And I know you're going to enjoy retirement because you get the opportunity to do some different things now than being tied down to certain schedules. One thing I will warn you about, though, is that you do have to find what you want to do, kind of establish your own schedule so that you don't get bored or that you feel like you got to be doing something else. But that time will come. It just takes a little time to plan those things out. So again, just really want to say happy retirement and that you'll enjoy it.
And I will say that it took John about a year before he finally felt his niche on what he really needed to do or wanted to do. And he had some really boring times and he looked kind of blah, like, I really don't know what to do. And that would drive me crazy. So Julie, make sure you have plenty of things to keep Mike busy to start off with, because it seems like you have all this free time, but yet at the beginning, it's kind of hard to know what to do with all that free time. But it has helped us be able to function more with, be able to do a lot of things with our grandkids. And John's been able to do a lot more with woodworking, things like that. So just have some things ready for Mike because he's going to need them. But miss you guys. Bye-bye. Happy retirement. Bye-bye.
Happy retirement.
Hey, 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 less than a minute. Congratulations, Coach Graham, on your retirement. I'm Tiffany Plew. I'm Emily Busberg. And we're from Indiana Christian Academy Whirlwinds, and we had you back in the late 80s, early 90s, and we just cannot believe you're retiring already, and wish you all the best.
We have such wonderful memories of Coach Graham. We grew up with him. He was a dad to our friend. We spent lots of time with their family at their house. He was our teacher and our coach. He was the guy that everybody loved. It didn't matter if you were a good student, a bad student, an athlete or not, everyone loved Coach Graham. We so appreciate you and all the time you invested in our lives.
Yes, I'll never forget all of the Pacer games and just the fun times that we had together with your family. Happy retirement, Coach.
Hey, Coach Graham. This is Tracy Campbell Tipton from Indiana Christian Academy in Anderson, Indiana. I'm here actually in the ICA gym. We're getting ready to do a whole huge renovation, new floor. Look, they've already painted over the normal ICA welcome and things like that. So it's kind of a mess in here right now because they've been redoing things. They took the stage out back there. So lots of changes here, all for the good actually. Just wanted to take a second to wish you a very happy retirement. Want to thank you and your family, Mrs. Graham, Lori, Jenny, Wendy. So have such fond memories of your family, and thank you so much for all your, I guess, being normal and try not to do it without crying, your mentorship. And you had a great balance of being a mentor and being a friend. So I want to thank you. Love you. Bye.
Well, hello, Mike. I hear that you are retiring, and I just wanted to congratulate you on a job well done. You have finished the race that the Lord gave you to run, and I know you are thankful for the opportunity you have had to influence so many lives of young people. And I want to thank you for all that you did for me in the motor coach business. You were, of course, one of our greatest drivers, never had an accident. I hope that you enjoyed your trips with particularly Andrew Phipps and getting to go out and see the West. And we certainly want to thank you for that also.
Hey, Coach Graham, happy retirement. I just know that your involvement in volleyball had a huge part to play in my life. I wouldn't have gone to the college I went to if it wasn't for our volleyball trips. Making it up to Maranatha each summer for volleyball camps opened my eyes to the possibilities there. That's where I met my husband. So many things would be different if it wasn't for the piece that you played in my life in those early years at Community Baptist Christian School. So I am so excited for you. I hope you enjoy retirement. And best wishes to you. And maybe someday we'll make it down to Florida and we can see you guys again.
Hey, Coach Graham, it's Steve Lair. Way back from your ICA days in the 70s. I think back when maybe dinosaurs roamed the earth or something like that. Anyway, hey, wanted to congratulate you on your upcoming retirement. Heard about that, and that's wonderful news. And I think even more wonderful is the fact that I didn't drive you to retirement early, so that's a good thing. So we'll let that go. Anyway, want to thank you for all the many life lessons you taught me growing up. They're in high school at ICA. The basketball that you taught me, big help. And just being a friend, especially during that time when I lost my father my sophomore year. I'll always remember just the comfort and the friendship that you provided. So thank you so much for that. So for you and Mrs. Graham, congratulations. Enjoy retirement. Have some fun there in Jacksonville. And hopefully we'll hear great news about you in the future. So, Coach, again,
I can't thank
congratulations
you enough.
And see you soon.
Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of kids, maybe even thousands of kids. I would say that if you would talk to them now, would only have extremely high marks and high praise for Mike Graham. There's only one Mike Graham, only one MRG, the only teacher who used to stand in the middle of the hallways and say, go to class, Mr. Halbert, you need to go to class right now. And I can't do a good imitation of that, but you were always good for a good laugh because of how you conducted yourself and tried to make our boring school days fun. And that was also something that all of us kids enjoyed. I wish you well, Coach, in your retirement. I hope you'll be able to travel. You and Julie, I know you guys like to travel, and I wish you well. I hope you guys get to travel a lot in your retirement. I hope you get to spend a lot of time with your kids and grandkids. And I can't thank you enough for all that you've done. And so I'll leave you with this. The picture that I submitted to Wendy has significant meaning to me. It's a picture of me on the side of the Swiss Alps there in Switzerland. I was in Switzerland for a meeting with my job and took that picture. And that picture symbolizes to me the journey that I'm on, frankly, that we're all on, in that we all climb mountains, and some days, some years, we're on the top of the mountains, and some days and some years we're on the bottom in the valleys. And I know that you've had your highs, and I know that you've had some lows in your life as well, but that picture represents to me the attributes that you taught me. To continue to give it all, to continue to climb that mountain, no matter how difficult it may be, and not to give up. And I'm going to do my best to finish strong. And I hope you as well, Coach, if the Lord doesn't return, that you'll enjoy your retirement and finish strong, just like you taught us. I love you, Coach. And may God give you a blessed retirement.
Coach Graham, congratulations on your retirement from coaching, and wow, what memories I have of those early days in my own coaching career and the impact that you had on my life as a mentor, as a leader, as a coach that makes a difference in lives, and you made a difference in my life. And I remember those early days of our Heritage Hall ICA rivalries, and the difficulty we had in just raising our level of competition to your level, and yet the challenges that we faced, and just the fellowship we enjoyed, even in establishing that brass ball trophy, and realizing that the results of the game were not nearly as important as the impact that we were making on our athletes. And Billy Graham said, a coach will impact more lives in one season than the average person does in an entire lifetime. And certainly you're that kind of a coach. And I can only describe or remember our relationship as iron sharpening iron. And I'm thankful for that impact that you had on my life all those years ago. And thankful that God's going to use you in a greater way in a new phase of your life. And as the teaching and coaching opportunities end for you, we know that you'll have a far greater impact in another area, in another realm, and the treasures you've laid up in heaven all these years of coaching are innumerable, and only eternity will tell the impact that you've truly had. And just wanted to say congratulations and thanks for the memories of those early years of my own coaching career. So God bless.
Hi, Coach Graham, and congratulations on your retirement. No one is more deserving of a fantastic retirement and all the good things that retirement has to offer than you are. One of my favorite things about being coached by you and the things that I've carried with me from that experience is the idea of that our team was always more than just like a sports team, any of the teams that I was on, but especially the volleyball team. You always placed more of an emphasis on making sure that we felt like a family and that you saw us more as an individual than a volleyball player. So no loss was ever the biggest loss in the world, and no win was ever the thing that defined us. I've always really treasured that and appreciated that, and it's actually made me want to eventually be a coach myself. So hopefully one day that'll be true. Again, thank you for everything you've done and for everything you did after me and my graduation time and all the teams that came before and after, and I hope you have a fantastic retirement. Bye.
Where do I begin? It has been an honor working with you for the last 15 years. You are such a godly man, full of wisdom and integrity. Our students have been blessed to have you as a leader over them. I am excited for what the future holds for you and Julie and all the adventures and traveling that y'all are going to be able to do. I cannot wait to hear all about them, especially your trip to Israel. I know that we're going to be able to see you around, but we will miss having you here every day, especially in our staff meetings and all of the music that comes in play from time to time to help lighten the load. I will miss you, and I am just, again, honored that I've been able to work with you for the last 15 years.
Coach Graham, huge congratulations. I was so excited for you when I heard that you were retiring. You deserve this more than anybody. It takes a special person to be successful at being a teacher, an athletic director, and a coach. And you're somebody that I've always looked up to. One of our first interactions we've had with each other was when I was a student at Eaglesview. I'll never forget it. You walked in the gym. You had so much stuff in your hands like you always did because you're always so busy and you're going here and there. But you went in your office, dropped it off, walked all the way across the gym just to help me out with my shooting technique. You were that kind of person to where that you were never too busy to help somebody, to coach somebody. You really are a huge mentor in my life. And even as a staff member there at Eaglesview, your door was always open. You were always willing to help me if I had any questions or to give me advice. And I was always so grateful for that. So I'm so excited and so happy for you, Miss Julie. I pray that you and the family truly enjoy retirement. Congratulations.
Hey, Mike, congrats. I know you're not going anywhere, but I know you're thinking about retiring and all that. And just in case you really do go through with this, I want to let you know, man, I am so grateful to have had you in my life. Not that you're going anywhere, but I'm so thankful for the impact you've had on me. I've loved you like a brother since the minute I met you, and I'm so grateful for you. You've had such an impact on so many people. I don't think you even realize how many people that you've impacted, but I can think especially selfishly of my own family, what you've meant to, you know, I think about my daughter Hannah. You know, she was able to go and play college volleyball at the college, the first college of her choice, and she still loves the game, loves coaching, and she loves coaching with you. She has a passion for it because of you, and I'm just thankful for that, and I know she is too. And I would like to take credit for hiring you at EVA, but I totally know that it was God who knew just what the school needed at the time that you came along. So thank you for listening to that and taking a chance and moving to Jacksonville, because you've just been a huge part of that school, the heartbeat of that school. But what you brought to EVA was class and everything you do. I appreciate everything from being an athletic director to being a teacher to being a contestant on EVA's American Idol. Yeah, don't think we'll forget ever the rendition of Bad to the Bone that you did when you walked up on stage and you walked right up to the mic stand and you scotch taped your lyrics to the mic stand before you started to sing. I was done before you even started the music. It was great. But Mike, you've always modeled a servant's heart for me and for everybody that knows you. And as your previous boss, I learned so much more from you than you could have ever learned from me. So I'm so thankful for that time we've had together. But there's people that you want to retire. You're not one of them. But I think of Marion. Like, what is Marion still doing there? She's older than you and she hasn't retired yet. So there's people that you want to retire, like Marion. What are you hanging on for, Marion? I'm just kidding. She's going to kill me later. But I love Marion. I know she could take a joke. So she's not older than Mike, but I'm just messing. She's my sister. Anyway, Mike, you're not one of those we want to retire, but to hold you back from retiring would be selfish, just because we can't imagine a day what EVA is going to look like without you there. It'd be selfish to keep you from doing what you deserve. And we're so thankful for what you've meant to this school. And I hope you enjoy the mess out of this time. And know that all of us send you with our prayers and with all of our love to you and Julie. Congratulations. You did it, bud.
Hey, Coach Graham, congratulations on your retirement.
Thanks for everything you've done for us. You sacrificed a lot to coach the volleyball teams.
Coach Graham, your love for Christ and the girls shone through all the sports that you coached. So thankful that I got to spend some time with you, and so happy for your retirement. Can't wait to see all the amazing adventures that you go on. We just wanted to say thank you from the Solano family.
Congratulations.
Hey, Granddad, just wanted to say congratulations and thank you so much for your many, many years of coaching and teaching in the classroom. These are memories and lessons I'll hold on to forever. Enjoy your retirement. Love you.
Hi there. Just wanted to get on and say hi. Happy retirement. I was thinking a lot about just the last several years, I mean my whole life actually, just being in the gym with Dad or running around the hallways while he was hosting a summer basketball camp, or you know, crazy memories of just fun times being at the school while Dad did some coaching. As I got older, I got to experience his coaching firsthand, be on the volleyball team, helping out with the softball team, just various sports that I was interested in that he participated in, as well as the coach or assistant coach. And it was just a pleasure being there with you, Dad, and the time and the patience that you would take to help me, especially in volleyball. I wasn't very good, so Dad would multiple times take me back to the gym later at night to practice my serves or practice passing with me. And I know that he, you know, he just took the time like that with a lot of people, not necessarily after school like he did with me as his daughter, but, you know, taking that time to help you understand and enjoy a sport that you were participating in. You know, and you saw that dedication on him or in him through his first school at ICA all the way to his last school there at Eaglesview, and the passion and dedication that he has to the students and what he does. And I'm just overwhelmed that, you know, you're my dad and that you've made such an impact on so many lives. And I'm excited for this next chapter in your life. I hope that you and Mom are able to travel, visit family, you can come see me or, you know, taking those trips that you always wanted to do and I hope that you truly enjoy it, and I love you, and I'm super excited for you. Love you. Bye.
I never thought this day would come. Happy retirement, Dad. Love you.
Hey, Dad. I just wanted to say that I'm so grateful I got to have you as a teacher. You were my high school Bible, history, geography teacher, and also a coach. You coached me in volleyball, and my friends and I loved having you, except for when you made us run, but it was good for us. And then you were a basketball coach, and I got to cheer for several of the teams that played for you when I was in high school, which was also fun. Just memories of you passing out peanut butter and chocolate chip sandwiches on the bus to people who had never tried it before, or you cutting up and singing too on the way home from an away game. I cherish those memories. And I thought about, even back at the beginning, how Mom would make sure that me, Lori, and Jenny had cheerleading outfits on when we were little, and you know, the megaphones and all of that. We would come to support you at the games, and it was so much fun. And I want to give a shout out to Mom, because over the years, she was an amazing coach's wife, supporting you and bringing us along and having so much fun. I'm really grateful for the sacrifice that you both made and that we got to be part of things. Not everyone can say as a kid that they were part of a lot of their parents' career. And so, and the grandkids too, grateful for that. And for the memories that I personally have with you, because you were a coach in Indiana, we went to high school basketball games, NBA games, where we met Reggie Miller, not once, but twice, and he remembered us. I treasure those times, and even to this day, how when the NCAA March Madness basketball tournament time comes, we watch the final game together, even if we're across the miles texting. And when the highlights come on with the One Shining Moment song, I'll always think of you, always. So I'm grateful. I love you, and happy retirement, Dad.
Hi, honey. I've been watching you coach for almost 50 years now. And in all those years, I've never seen you lose your cool. I've never seen you raise your voice to a player or to an official, although your face may have turned red a few times, but you always managed to keep it together. And I also admire how you've stayed physically active and tried to show the players what to do rather than just tell them what to do. I should have known when we got married in a gym that we would spend a lot of time there. And I remember when our girls were little that one of them told a visitor, she pointed to the locker room door and told them that you lived there. And we all got a good laugh out of that. It's also been a blessing to hear from many of your players over the years and realize that you have had an influence over them. I know this really won't be the end of your desire to teach and influence young people, because I've just known you too long for that. So I just want to say, girls, I hope you can find a man like Mike. And boys, I hope you'll be a man like Mike. And parents, I hope you'll teach your children as best you can to be full of love and integrity, the way Mike's parents taught him. And lastly, I hope that athletic directors and teachers will follow your example, because looking back now, we can see something we weren't sure of then. There was a famous teacher named Krista McAuliffe who said, "I touch the future, I teach." Now we are in the future, and we can see that we have touched the future. And I pray that you will also realize that you, by teaching, are touching the future. Thank you again, honey, for loving me well and faithfully. I love you.
Coach Mike Lightfoot here, former coach of Bethel College. And I just want to really congratulate you, Mike, on a tremendous run. To be able to be in this profession for 48 years is truly, truly incredible. And to invest in the young people that you've been involved in and the difference you've made in their life, I just want to thank you on behalf of coaches around the country that look at you as a model of excellence. So enjoy your retirement. I know you really won't retire, you'll just reinvest. But congratulations again on one incredible run, and thank you for all the lives that you've touched. You know, Billy Graham said that a coach impacts more lives in a year than most people do in a lifetime. So think about how many lives that you have impacted. Thank you, Coach.
Hello, Coach Graham. This is Steve Alford. It's an honor for me to say congratulations on an incredible career. 47 years of teaching, 48 years of coaching, all that you've done at Indiana Christian Academy in one of my favorite cities being Anderson, not far from my hometown of Newcastle. I know I did have a day of mourning several years ago when the wigwam was shut down. People say, why is it a day of mourning? It's because my love of Indiana basketball and how big a gym the wigwam was. And I think they asked me that because the last time I was in the wigwam, I missed two free throws in a row that cost my team a game. So not great memories about the wigwam, but incredible memories of playing high school basketball in the great state of Indiana. So I just want to say congratulations on an incredible career, one that you have touched so many lives. And I wish you happy retirement. Congratulations to this day. And I hope that you and Julie can enjoy this time, get to do the things that you want to do, and enjoy family and friends throughout. So again, Coach, congratulations on an incredible career. I wish you all the best. God's blessings to you and your family.
Hello, Mike. I was happy to be included on this celebration of your retirement. You always loved teaching, and I know you enjoyed this year of rest. You've been a blessing, and I'm happy and proud to call you my son. I love you. Your mom.